When a viewer tipped us off to this guy selling a car, Target 8 went undercover to find out what he was up to. What we discovered sparked a state investigation. Now, we've warned you before about people rolling back odometers so they can jack up the price on old cars. Thousands of cars on Michigan roads may not be what you think they are.
Other than scratches, there's no rust, or, you know.
We checked out the car this man tried to sell online.
What was the price?
I was asking $3,000 best offer.
He knew we were recording everything.
Do you care if I take some pictures?
Yeah, sure, really sure. Nice. Sure.
What Antonio Lopez didn't know, he was talking to a Target 8 investigator.
Only 126,000 miles. Engine is clean.
Did you say what, 126,000 miles?
Yes.
Okay.
Close to 127. Engine always kept clean.
We got a shot of the odometer, and it did show just under 127,000 miles. But that's nowhere near the mileage Carfax showed on the 1997 Honda Civic. We ran the vehicle identification number.
Someone had rolled back the odometer 205,000 miles. It's right there.
And the car's previous owner, Mark Labonte, who tipped us off, showed me a receipt from an old repair.
Right. It had 254. I put another 80,000 miles on it.
In 2008, the car already had 254,000 miles on it. And just days after Labonte sold it, he spotted it back online for about four times the price he had sold it for.
And I got a little suspicious, and as I read the ad, it said that the car had 127,000 miles on it, and that kind of made some alarm bells go off.
Could that be possible?
No, unless he drove in reverse for a long, long way.
We're talking about a car that has 205,000 more miles on it than what was advertised. When Target 8 checked out the car the first time.
You don't run Carfax? How come? Aren't you careful about that?
Perhaps we asked too many questions. Less than an hour later, Lopez texted our undercover buyer saying the car had been sold and stopped taking our calls. But we discovered the car still sitting where we met him, so we waited. And when Lopez showed up, he drove off in the car. We followed him to a house, but he rushed inside as we walked up.
Can you please send Tony out here? Can I talk to Tony, please?
Another man at the house told us Lopez had just sold him the car and started explaining the mileage before we even asked about it.
34,000.
He told you 334,000 miles?
That's what it's
because that's not what he told one of our people who went and
well,
tried to
you
buy
know what?
The car.
Your people, I don't know, he didn't lie to me. He's a good guy. I know him for a fact.
Labonte says they're misrepresenting the car.
Actually, I was complaining to a friend about the lack of police intervention and a support on an issue like that. And they said, why don't you contact Target 8?
And Target 8 went to the state.
You're Michigan's Secretary of State. Is there something your office can do?
Well, anytime we can help, we try. Many times these become civil suits.
We asked the Secretary of State's office to pull title and registration information on Lopez, uncovering nearly a dozen cars linked to Yariel Antonio Lopez and Wilfredo Lopez Mendez. They showed a couple different addresses, including the one we tracked Antonio to. Our inquiry prompted a state investigation. He didn't lie to you. Why did he lie to one of us?
I'm photographing. I don't need to talk to you. I bought the car legally. Go someplace else.
No, but explain to me.
I bought the car legally. I paid for it.
Can I see the odometer?
No, you cannot come into my property.
I can't see the odometer?
It's definitely a concern for this area and for anybody that might need a reliable used car. You've got to be very, very, very careful.
Now, the Secretary of State's office tells me it is investigating a possible unlicensed dealer in this case. So here's what you can do. You can run the VIN through a service like Carfax, but keep in mind, Carfax won't always show a vehicle's current mileage. So you should also ask to see service records showing the mileage and consider whether the wear and tear on the car is consistent with the mileage. 20,000 cars in Michigan have a rollback odometer, according to Carfax. We have several helpful links with this story on our website, woodtv.com. And we are taking this a step further for you. Tomorrow morning, live on Daybreak, we'll have a collision expert showing you how you can spot a rollback odometer.